Ernest Rutherford was a brilliant scientist. He performed a number of experiments to study the structure of atom. From one such experiment, he was able to give a very important conclusion. He presented a seminar on his work. Let's see what he presented. He was aware of the structure of atom given by J.J. Thomson, according to which the atom was a positive sphere and the electrons were embedded on this positive sphere. Rutherford performed an experiment in which he took alpha particles. Alpha particles are the positively charged particles. He projected these particles on the atom. He expected something like this to happen. If Thomson's model was correct, then the atom is a positive solid sphere. So all the positive particles, that is all the alpha particles, should have been deflected. When they strike the atom, all the particles should have been deflected. But when he performed the experiment he performed is known as alpha particle scattering experiment. He used this device. This device ejects the alpha particles. He made the alpha particles ejected from this device to pass on a gold foil. So he saw that most of the alpha particles passed through and some of them were deflected. So Rutherford had used a gold foil for his experiment. This is because he wanted a very thin layer to perform the experiment. And gold can be made into a very thin sheet, and this is the reason that he took gold foil for the experiment. So when he performed the experiment, he was expecting that all the alpha particles would be deflected or they would bounce back, since Thomson had said that the atom is a solid positive sphere. If it's a solid sphere, therefore he expected that all the alpha particles would be deflected. But when he performed the experiment, he observed that most of the alpha particles went straight through the foil. And therefore, he concluded that the atom contains a large empty space. So according to his observation, he was able to conclude that the atom contains a large empty space, since most of these alpha particles went straight through the foil without any deflection. This means that most of the space in an atom is empty. Also, he was expecting that the particles would be deflected or they would bounce back. But he observed that some particles were deflected from their path and very few alpha particles. They were deflected by very large angles or they completely bounced back. So there were very few alpha particles who showed this behavior. So he was able to conclude that the nucleus, he called the positively charged center as the nucleus. It's the positively charged center because all the protons are concentrated in this nucleus. The size of the nucleus is very small, and it is in the nucleus that all the mass of the atom resides. Since most of the alpha particles went straight through the foil, this means that all the mass of the atom is concentrated in a very small area in the atom, and he called that very small area as the nucleus, in which all the mass and the positive charge of the atom resides. And the size of the nucleus is very small since only some alpha particles were deflected. Also, he was able to conclude that the electrons revolve in the empty space. We know that the electrons have negligible mass as compared to the mass of proton. That is why the electrons do not deflect the alpha particles that were projected on the atom. And so they revolve in the empty space around the nucleus. So this is how he proposed the structure of the atom. Since most of the alpha particles went straight through, so most of the space in an atom is empty. Some particles were deflected and very few bounced back. This means that the entire mass of the atom is concentrated in the center of the atom, which he called nucleus. The entire mass and the positive charge, that is all the protons, of the atom are concentrated in this central part of the atom. Since the electrons have negligible mass as compared to the protons, so the electrons do not deflect these alpha particles and they revolve around the nucleus of the atom in the empty space around the nucleus. So this is how he proposed the structure of the atom. So this was the gold foil that he had taken. See what's happening inside the gold foil at the atomic level. So you'll observe that most of the alpha particles pass straight through and only some of the particles are deflected when they strike the nucleus. So on the basis of Rutherford's model of the atom, which subatomic particle is present in the nucleus of the atom? So according to Rutherford, the atom contains a large empty space. The entire mass and the positive charge of the atom is concentrated in the central part, which is known as the nucleus. Since the entire positive charge is concentrated in the nucleus, this means that the subatomic particle present in the nucleus is the proton. Since protons are positively charged, so all the protons are concentrated in this central part, known as the nucleus of the atom. So let's see again how Rutherford was able to come to the structure of the atom as he had proposed. So he observed from the alpha particle scattering experiment that most of the alpha particles went straight through the foil without any deflection. And that is why he concluded that the atom contains a large empty space. Also, he observed that some particles were deflected and very few particles bounced back. Based on this observation, he was able to conclude that the nucleus, which is the positively charged center of the atom, all mass of the atom resides in the nucleus. Since only few particles are deflected and very few bounce back, this means that all the mass of the atom is concentrated in this small part of the atom, which is known as nucleus, and size of nucleus is very small. Since most of the particles pass straight through without any deflection, this means that the nucleus of the atom is very small as compared to the atom. Also, the electrons revolve in this empty space. Since the mass of electrons is very less as compared to the mass of protons, they do not cause any deflection in the path of the alpha particles. So these electrons revolve in the empty space around the nucleus. Also, he was able to observe that the atom is electrically neutral. Since an atom is electrically neutral, so the total number of protons in the atom is equal to the total number of electrons in the atom. Protons are positively charged, electrons are negatively charged. So to maintain the electrical neutrality of the atom, the number of protons is equal to the number of electrons. And based on these observations, Rutherford gave his model, which is known as the Rutherford's model of the atom, in which most of the space in the atom is empty. The entire mass and positive charge of the atom is concentrated in the central part of the atom, which he called the nucleus, and the electrons revolve around the nucleus in this empty space. Since an atom is electrically neutral, so the number of protons in the atom is equal to the number of electrons. So this is the Rutherford's model of the atom.